Good morning, children. In today's session, I'm going to take class in science for 5th standard. It is for term 3. We are going to start, children, term 3 portions. Lesson 1, our environment. From the second, from the term 2, one lesson is there, that is second lesson. It will be added in the annual exam. So now we are going to start the term 3 portion. First lesson, our environment. Now, whatever I'm writing on the board, you can take down in your notebook, children. After buying the book, you can see the book and learn, okay? Now, our environment. Environment means what? That is nature, surrounding us, okay, surrounding. Then environment is everything that is around us. So already said, whatever it's around, it's in nature, it is called as an environment. There are two types of environment, physical environment and biological environment. So physical environment and biological environment, okay. Now, physical environment includes all non-living things. Physical environment includes all non-living things like land. Example, land, water, air. All these comes under physical environment. So, physical environment means non-living things like land, water and air. And biological environment includes like living things. And the examples is like plants, animals. Okay, plants and animals, all these comes under living things, which is a biological environment. Natural environment has lot of economic values. Plants and animals in our environment are useful to us in a number of ways. So plants and animals are very much useful to us in a number of ways, like animals like cow, buffalo and goat. All these give us milk, which is very useful. Okay, these animals are very useful, which give us milk. Some animals are used for transportation, like horses, buffaloes. All these are used for transportation, that is going from one place to another place. And these animals are raised in farms. Farms are another panna and solralia, kori panna and the mari solralia, like that. In this lesson, we will learn about dairy farms, poultry farms, apiculture, manures and vermicompost. First, we will go to the farms. So, farms are another panna and solralia, kori panna, mari larku bodha, it's called as farms. Farming is the activity of growing crops and raising livestock. So, farming, agriculture, that is growing the crops, okay? And raising livestock means domestic animals. Domestic animals are raising na valakuram solralli and domestic animals are nama valakuram. So, this is called as a raising the livestock. It's a part of agriculture. So, growing crops is agriculture is nothing but a growing crops. Agriculture is the cultivation of land and breeding. Breeding na reproduction. Ina perikon solralli ya? Of animals and plants to provide food, woods and medicinal plant to sustain. To sustain means to support and enhance life. But farming is more profitable than agriculture. So agriculture vida edhu nalladhu? Farming. So it is done on a commercial scale. An area of land with fields and buildings that is devoted primarily to growing crops or domestic animals or both as a business is called as a farm. Now that's large scale farms is there. Middle size and small size. You have three types of farms. Large scale farms, which has one or two major crops of animals. That is large scale, medium size and small size. Okay, there are three types. So in the largest scale, what you can see, that is one or two major crops or animals is rare. And in middle size and small size, grow different types of crops as well as animals. Next, we'll see the, in that we'll see the dairy farm. Now, dairy farming is a type of agriculture, okay, that focuses on extraction of milk. So, dairy products are menna solro, like cheese, butter, chocolates, idellame vandha dairy products, illaya. So, that is extracted from the milk, okay, from the milk only all these comes. And preparation of various milk products like cheese, butter, curd is a thayir, the butter, and the lark, the dairy products. So, high milk producing cows. High milk producing and the cows on the nariya milk namakurukanga, along with bulls and oxen, are raised in dairy farms. Dairy farms are enough pandranga, balakranga, raising. Other animals found in these farms. So, and then matha animals from the farms na pakrona, goats, sheep, as well as the camels, we can see. Other than this, cows, bulls and oxen, we can see the animals like goats, sheep and camels. Next is the cattle breeds. So India there are about 26 cattle breeds. Cattle na ungalku enna nu theriyum illaya, aadu maadu la valakkuraangala, that is 26 cattle. There are how many breeds? 26 breeds na different types of cows adellame. They are domesticated for milk. Avanga edhukku valakkuraanga? For the milk, then agricultural work, vivasayathukku, then transportation, that is from going from one place to another. For all these are raised. So for what they are raised in? One for milk, next for agriculture, then for transportation, and for many other needs also these cattles are raised. So how many cattle breeds are there? 26. And Gir, Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Kangayam and Ongole are some of the cattle breeds found in India. So what are the cattle breeds children? Gir, Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Kangayam and Ongole, these are the cattle breeds, and these are found in the different states of India. Okay, now we'll see now where they are can found. Gir cattle is found in the Gujarat, Rajasthan, then Sahiwal in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Red Sindhi, where you can find this? In Andhra. Then Malvi, Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh. Nagari, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan. Kangayam, you can see this in Tamil Nadu, and Ongole in the Andhra. So all these cattle breeds are found in these states. Okay, then India has the largest number of livestock. Livestock means what is it? Domestic animals. Okay, India has the largest number of domestic animals in the world, holding 281 million livestock. So in 2008, our country is the second largest number of cattle in the world. It's the second largest country in the world with 175 million. Okay, million. And apart from these animals, what you can see? Buffaloes. Buffaloes and the Yeruman Sodonia, buffaloes are also domesticated in India. Now, other than these animals, even buffaloes are also domesticated in India. There are 7 buffalo breeds in India. So in 26 cattle breeds, 7 buffalo breeds are there in India. Buffaloes produce more amount of milk than cows. Okay, underline the sentence children, that buffaloes produces milk than cows. So also buffalo milk has more nutrients than the cow's milk. So cow's milk avida buffalo milk la enna irukku, nariya nutrients irukku. So Murra, Jafarabadi, Padavari and Surti are the buffalo breeds that are found in India. Now India is the biggest buffalo milk producer in the world. So India is the biggest buffalo milk producer in the world. And some of the buffalo breeds found in the country, here this is again given here, table is there. Buffalo breeds, what are the buffalo breeds? I said Murra, Badavari, Jafarabadi, Surti, Mahasana, Nagpuri and Neeli Ravi. So in this first we will see the Murra. It is Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. In all these three states this cattle is found. Then Badavari in Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Jafarabadi is in Gujarat. Then Surti is in Rajasthan and Gujarat. Mahasana in Gujarat. Nagpuri, Central and South India. And Neeli Ravi in the Punjab and Haryana. So all these cattle breeds are found in these states. Then feeding, that is Thivanam Chodaniya. Cattle need nutritious feed in order to be healthy. So all these cattle, that is cows, buffaloes, goats, sheep, camels, all these need nutritious food to eat, to be poor, to be healthy and produce high milk yield. So if we eat healthy food only, what they do? They give us high milk yield. And these cattle feed includes roughage. Roughage means plants food like nuts, seeds, fruits, all these comes in the roughage and concentrates. The roughage contains high amount of fiber and it includes fodder na thivanam solrali adu. Then hay means grass pulled. Then straw and silage, that is straw is nothing from the cotton plant you get, and silage is a green foliage crops. Okay, all these. Then concentrates include broken grams, cereals na danyangal solraliya, millets thinai vagaigal, and rice polish, cotton seeds and oil cakes. Oil cakes are nothing which is used for the livestock. Okay, apart from these feed, cattle need adequate amount of fresh water. So apart from these food, they need fresh water also to drink. Okay, enough amount, adequate amount of fresh water. Then what are the disease we can find in these animals? Foot and mouth disease. Okay, foot and the paadam solraliya, then mouth disease, and anthrax is some of the common diseases found among the cattle. So நம்ம cattle இந்த மாதிரி disease and பார்க்கலாம், like foot and mouth disease, anthrax, இதெல்லாம் disease நம்ம வந்து we can find in the cattle. Now maintaining proper sanitation is necessary to stop the spread of these diseases. Sanitation உங்களுக்கு கரெக்டா இருந்தா தான் உங்களுக்கு என்ன ஆகும், இந்த diseases வந்து நம்ம ஸ்டாப் பண்ணலாம் ஸ்ப்ரெட் ஆகாம இருக்கிறதுக்கு. டைம்லி வேக்சினேஷன், இன்ஜெக்ஷன் போடுறாங்க இல்லையா, கேன் ப்ரிவென்ட் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த டிசீசஸ். ஈவன் த வேக்சினேஷன் இஸ் கிவன் டு த அனிமல்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. ஸோ டைம்லி வேக்சினேஷன், கரெக்ட் டைம்ல உங்களுக்கு வேக்சினேஷன் கொடுத்தோம்னா இந்த டிசீஸ் எல்லாம் ஸ்ப்ரெட் ஆகாம நம்ம ஸ்டாப் பண்ணலாம். தென் யூசஸ், நெக்ஸ்ட் வில் கோ டு த யூசஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் கேட்டல். கேட்டல் ஆர் யூஸ் டு அஸ் இன் அ நம்பர் ஆஃப் வேஸ், சம் ஆஃப் தெம் ஆர் லிஸ்டட் பிலோ. வி கெட் மில்க் ஃப்ரம் கவுஸ். ஸோ ஃப்ரம் வேர் we get the milk from cows. The cow's milk contains essential minerals needed for us, okay. Cow's milk contain much amount of nutrients and minerals from them. So bullocks are used to plow land, harvest. Plow land na cultivate pandrathu, harvest na arvadai solradhu, that is gathering the crops, and thrashing na beat pandra the crops, nama adikkrom illaya beat pandrom illaya, that is a thrashing crops. So bullocks are used for this, that is for plowing the land and to harvest and thrash. So all these bullocks are used, and cattle are employed in transportation also. Transportation means I already explained to you, it is moving from one place to another place. So this cattle is used also in the transportation. Then cattle dung, dungna and the sanin solraliya, are used as a manure. It is used as fuel, okay, and for the generation of the biogas. Then panchagavya is an ayurvedic medicine used in agriculture, vivasayathukku, to control pest and fungi. It's a mixture of dung and urine of cows, fresh milk, curd, thair, jaggery, vellum and ghee. Then leather goods are also manufactured from this cattle hides, okay. Next we'll go to the poultry farms. In poultry farms, avian species, avian means birds, okay, avian means what, birds, are reared and bred for the purpose. Are reared na avanga valukranga and bred, puridha, ina perukom, for the purpose of egg, meat or both. For egg, meat and both also, okay, for this they are reared or valukranga. Fowls, ducks, geese, turkeys and some varieties of pigeon are the most commonly reared species in the poultry farms. Now chicken occupy 90% of the total poultry. So poultry la மற்ற இதெல்லாம் பேர்ட்ஸ் எல்லாம் இருக்கும், அதில் வந்து சிக்கன் தான் 90% இஸ் ஹோல்டிங் தேர் இன் த போல்ட்ரி, ஓகே. போல்ட்ரி பேர்ட்ஸ் க்ரோன் ஃபார் மீட் ஆர் கால்ட் ப்ராய்லர்ஸ். ஸோ மீட்டுக்கு மட்டும் அவங்க வளர்க்குறாங்கன்னா தே ஆர் கால்ட் ஆஸ் அ ப்ராய்லர்ஸ், ஓகே. ஸோ போல்ட்ரி பேர்ட்ஸ் க்ரோன் ஃபார் மீட் தே ஆர் கால்ட் ஆஸ் ப்ராய்லர்ஸ், ஓகே. And layers are the female fowls grown for egg production. So egg production na, for the egg production they are called as the layers, and they are the female fowls, okay, female hens. So for the meat, broilers, and for the egg production they are called as the layers, and the female fowls are used for this. And the poultry industry is important in providing a balanced diet for human population. For human population, ipo namakku vanda avangalukku kitta irundha nam poultry la irundha namakku enna kedaikudhu, egg, meat, ellame. So it's balancing the human population. Proper management of poultry includes both hatching, rearing, housing, sanitation and prevention of disease, and a sound marketing system. In Tamil Nadu, famous poultry farms, enna enna poultry farms engena paakala nam Tamil Nadu la, in Namakkal, Palladam and Chennai. So indha edathila la vandha nama poultry farms we can see, okay. So the famous poultry farms in Tamil Nadu are Namakkal, Palladam and Chennai. These are the three places. Now next we'll see the breeds. There are more than 100 breeds of fowls. Fowls are classified on the basis of the utility to man, how it is used to the man. They are meat types. Already I said meat means broiler. Then egg type, layer, and dual. Dual means both meat and egg. Okay, meat and egg. Okay, children. So what are the on the basis of it, that is meat type, I said broiler, egg type means layers, and dual, that is both. Then Asal, Chittagong, Gagas, Basra, Brahma and Cochin are some of the breeds found in our country. So local and indigenous birds are reared in rural places. So these birds have a poor meat production compared to the broilers and the layers. Now, but meat and egg from this type of poultry is better than the commercial poultry. So the meat and the egg poultry is better. Okay. See, do you know they have given? India ranks 5th in poultry production in the world. So India ranks 5th. India. What is the rank of India in this position? 5th position, okay, in the world for the poultry farm. And white Leghorn is the most egg yielding breed in the world. What children? White Leghorn. White Leghorn is the most egg yielding breed in the world. Then next is the feeding. Now poultry feeding means avangalukku enna saapadu kodukkanum illaya. Poultry birds needs proteins, carbohydrates, fats, minerals and vitamins for egg and meat production. அவங்க நல்லா egg and meat production நம்ம கொடுக்கணும்னா அவங்களுக்கு நியூட்ரிஷியஸ் ஃபுட்டும் போகணும் இல்லையா, லைக் ப்ரோட்டீன்ஸ், கார்போஹைட்ரேட்ஸ், இது எல்லாமே அவங்க ஃபுட்டில் இருந்தால் தான் தே கேன் ஈல்ட் வித் எக் அண்ட் மீட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன். பாஜ்ரா, பார்லி, மெய்ஸ், வீட், ரைஸ் பிரான், ஜோஹர் அண்ட் தீஸ் ஆர் வெஜிடபிள்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபீட் கிவன் டு த போல்ட்ரி பர்ட். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த நியூட்ரியன்ஸ் கிவன் டு த போல்ட்ரி ஃபார் த எக் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் அண்ட் த மீட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன். நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் த போல்ட்ரி ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ். Poultry products benefit us in many ways, okay, like egg, meat and manure. These are the three main benefits we get from the poultry. What is it? Egg, then meat and the manure. All these three are the important that we get from them. Poultry birds are good source of nutritive food. So they give us a nutritious food, and eggs laid by the poultry are rich source of protein. So egg is a rich source of protein which is good for the human consumption. Then these are easily digestible also. So these can be easily digested, and they contain, what are the minerals they contain? This egg, like calcium, potassium and iron, vitamins and moderate amount of fat, less amount of fat only we can see in this, okay. Then their feathers, these are used for making pillows and quilts. Quilts means velvet, okay. All these are used in making pillows and quilts. Now dropping in the fecus and the of the poultry birds are used as a manure and it's highly valuable for the crops, okay. The it is nutritious for the healthy for the crops here. So we'll continue in the next class, children, the other half of the lesson. So we'll see in the next class. Thank you.